back when you feel like calling me. You got the best of me. You got me losing sleep. I've been hopeful, baby. I was hoping maybe that you cross my path. I've been sinking lately, and it's hard to move. Think I'm stuck on you.
Hello. This place is a mess. Let's clean it up.
What if we run out of time and second chances? Empty-handed. I would love. Would you love me better if I go? I'm not home. I would love. Can we trust the stars above to let us know? And go. You only got this life. No guarantees and stars align. Stars about to let us know how to go.
Tell me if I got it wrong, but you don't wanna be alone. Spend the evening by yourself, but you'll miss me when it's getting late. Got it all, babe. Say phones when you're ready. I'm here when you need me. I'm yours if you let me. Got it all, babe. Say phones when you're ready. Why are you turning me on? Why are you telling me you want me down? Done it, I done this before you fall. I won't catch you, don't know I'm stalling. Cause you love to have them all crying. Gonna be sweet, telling me you need me. But I'm from a city that's high school. I give them the cinema, I go. Cause you a bad man, if she don't love money. She break grass real fast like on money. When I swim down to the deep.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Pumzi Limbata, and for those of you who are new to this channel, we are called Commissioned, where I share anything and everything that inspires me, as well as my faith and the word of God and my life experiences, personal development, and anything and everything that inspires me. I think I said that twice, but never mind. So hi guys, it's been quite a while since I put out a vlog, and simply because April has been like it's been a packed month, right? Because I don't want to say it's been busy or eventful, because it's like I haven't even been doing much, except I'm just involved in quite a lot at work, and I'm involved in quite a lot at church, and I've been going into the office quite a lot. So I've been exerting myself like physically and mentally. So it's just, yeah, it's been quite a lot. And at the same time, it's been very peaceful. It's been very still. Like when I get in the house, I am just chilling. So it's been like mixed, you know. And yeah, I haven't really been out to dine out and things like that. And I actually took stock that, like, if you compare my life from last year to what it is this year, it is so different in so many aspects. Like, so many things are new. It's like I'm living a whole new life. Don't even ask me like how, but I am, you know. And anyway, so yeah, like I said, I've been physically going into the office, whereas like I had started being so used to working from home. And I've been obviously exercising as well. I've maintained that, thank God. It's not easy, because like my primary goal right now is weight loss, and that's not happening. But we move and we keep on moving. It's fine, it will catch me along the way, but I'll just continue to do what I need to do. And then my secondary goal obviously is like just overall health and well-being and mental well-being as well, because it's very good for, you know, just release and all of that, and endorphins and all those things. So anyway, so it's been, yeah, it's been just interesting, a balance of trying to juggle so many things. But I'm here now. So what you'll also notice is that I'm now in the future. I'm not even in April, but this is the only time I've actually gotten to sit down and record. Oh no, I'm lying. I recorded, and it just didn't work out. I literally sat down for an hour, recorded a whole installment, but when I looked at it, I was like, damn, this energy is off, because I was just so exhausted, so tired and drained. So then I was like, nah, I gotta give you guys like the best, you know. I gotta give you the best of me, you know. You know when you watch something and you're like, I'm tiring myself just listening, I'm like, I'm exhausting myself, you know. So if I'm boring myself, obviously like I can't put that out, you know. So that happened like once, it happened again, and it might have happened a third time. But I was like, you know what, okay, let's just put this away and we'll record when we've got energy and like a little bit more restored. So I'm making a habit of trying to sleep earlier, because half of that is just sleeping so late, like around 12, 1, and then I'm drained. So I'm trying to go to bed now at like 9, so I've got energy for the next day. But overall, never mind all of that stuff, I feel like this year is just a very peaceful year for me. And I did set that intention out at the start as well. Like I remember when I bought like my daily journal, I chose one that has the verse that says, be still and know. And that scripture, when you think of it in totality, it says, be still and know that I am God. And so I chose it intentionally, because I was like, yes, this is what my year is going to be about. I feel like after the pandemic, you know, there was just some residual stress that we carried even after the pandemic, you know. So I feel like a lot of that was playing out last year for me, and I was just experiencing a lot of worry. I was worried about so much, you know. And yeah, so at the end of the year, I just told myself, I have worried enough to last me a lifetime, and I'm giving that up, and I just want to be still and know that He is God, because He is God. He is God. You know, the things that I was worrying about, I had no business worrying about, because I couldn't even control them. And so I'm finding that this year I'm experiencing stillness and peace. And now, God being so faithful, I set that intention and I went about my business. But in the last couple of weeks, He's also then been saying, rest, you know, because I feel like it's my nature to want to control the situation, control things, control the outcome, because I want to work hard at stuff, right? So that's just, it just comes naturally. However, God is saying, no, rest, you know. And the scripture that says, there remains a Sabbath rest for the people of God, and those who have entered His rest will cease from their works, just as God did. And so I started to investigate this Sabbath rest and entering into God's rest. And when I think about it, like, how can you resist? How can you resist it? Because it's such a beautiful invitation. You know, I love a beautiful invitation, you know. So this warmth from God that requires you to rest from your struggles, from your fears, from your worries, rest from control and everything. Just leave it to God. And when you think about how a Christian should live, and how He says the just shall live by faith, you know, it really opens your mind to how we ought to live stress-free, problem-free, because we have a God who is able and capable of defeating every kind of obstacle. So there's really no reason to fear or to worry or to lack faith and trust in God. And I mentioned lacking faith and trusting in God because that's also signs that you are not in God's rest. You know, when I looked at the scriptures, I then discovered that the people that God said in His word, in His anger, He said, they shall never enter my rest. And He was angry, you know. I was so touched that, like, damn, these people hurt God, you know. And He was talking to the children of Israel because they were so filled with unbelief. They were so filled with disobedience. And so God said, these guys, they're not going to enter the promised land, the land filled with milk and honey and peace and serenity, because what's required to enter into that land is faith. It's faith. So the word that was preached to them, it didn't profit them at all, because they did not mix it with faith. God, having done so much for the Israelites, He provided for them in the wilderness, He carried them, He was the cloud that showed them when to move, which direction to go, He sent them manna from heaven, but they did not believe, and they were wanting to praise idols and questioning Moses, questioning Joshua. There was just so much strife and self-trust and striving and quarreling and lack of faith. And so all of these things are little symptoms of the deeper sickness of unbelief, of not entering into God's rest. And so, you know, I was just like, damn, these people angered God so much because of their lack of faith and trust and unbelief. And I don't want to be that, because the scripture then goes on to warn us. It says, fear not entering into this rest. And it says, diligently seek after this rest. We need to be diligent about it, you know, which goes to show that it's not going to happen naturally, because naturally we want formulas, you know, we want solutions that we can see and understand. But actually with God, He says, rest, whatever it is, the answer is rest. And I don't know who this is for. I know that it's for me, you know, but the answer is rest, just rest. So I thank God for that nudging, that revelation, and the peace that He's been giving me in just life. You know, if I think of my life last year, I don't know if I've already said this, I was one worried hun, hey? I was one worried hun. And this year, I ain't worried about a damn thing. I ain't worried about nothing. This year, if it requires my worry, it's just not gonna have it, you know? So I really thank God for the peace, for the stillness, for who he is. You know, he's a solid rock and a foundation. And really, when you have God, there's nothing to fear, there's nothing to worry about. Just to continue with the vlog, the next piece is just, I didn't get a chance, like I said, to record any intros to what I was doing and what was going on, but this next part that you're gonna see, I was just chilling with some new friends, which are just some amazing ladies that I either recently met or Unamhla, we went to high school together, but we'd actually never ever spoken until she moved to London. So I just invited everybody to my space, and it was just so beautiful and heartfelt and heartwarming and just vibes and amazing. So yeah, anyway, it's good to catch up with you guys. I'll probably catch you somewhere in the middle, sitting right here introducing the next thing, because your girl did not even pick up a camera. Oh, I did. Anyway, you know the story. Cheers. Satisfying you while I keep bleeding. I don't know why you act like you're innocent. You wanna take a piece of my heart again. I get you, cause I just don't want you. Something in your eyes, the way you stare me that I like. I wanna let you go, but it's like something.
Towards the middle of last year, but it was a bit drawn out. Like, I was healed pretty quickly, but the long-term symptoms that remained was inflammation. And maybe 3 weeks after, I felt like okay, respiratory-wise. I felt like when I get up, I don't know how to describe it, but it just felt like there's water in my legs, like there's this uncomfortable feeling. And I was like, surely I'm swollen inside.
Yeah.
You don't even know how to describe it, because like I've never felt this way.
Yeah.
But my body feels like it's just not
straight. Yeah, it's not.
I don't know.
No,
yes. Because like, what the heck? So then other things started to happen as well, because then I was short of vitamin D, but I didn't know at the time.
By
the
way,
I
just
emotionally, mentally, physically, the COVID, isolating, and then it's like the pain, because then the whole shortage of vitamin D thing, I was feeling pain in my leg, pain in my spine, pain in my bones, I'm tired all the time. Finally, I kept on going to the doctor as well, and my private health care hadn't kicked in at the time, so it's NHS. Just to get on the phone and have them listen to you, because you have to phone at 8 in the morning if you want to have an appointment, right? There are no appointments in 3 weeks time.
Oh,
in the
gosh.
3 weeks on the day they cancelled it.
Oh.
I was like, guys, honestly, really, you know, fine, I booked another one, then it was in 2 weeks time.
That's like
that's
5 weeks
of
yeah.
Not knowing what's going on with you.
Because
right?
Why?
I had to go to Munich for work. And I was literally like out there like this. Literally like limping everywhere. Hi, okay,
so
fine.
Terrible.
It was really, really
terrible.
Finally I saw the doctor. I know from how I feel that I'm no longer inflamed. So what I did was take a vitamin D and then guys, these people need to start paying me. They need to start paying me because I've put so many people on mushroom powder. So there's this company called DIRTEA, and they sell mushroom powder. There's four different categories of what it like helps with. The one helps with like good sleep. The other one, the one I take, helps me with like, it's got lots of antioxidants, helps reduce inflammation, it's got vitamin D, balances your hormones. So I was like
the dark mushroom.
Excited right now because I ordered a new Bible and it arrived this evening, and I'm gonna study it for the first time. I've never been more excited. You know, it's long overdue. I needed like a study Bible, and it's got here, and I cannot wait for getting deeper into the word, and the way that it sets out, the way things are written, the way the headings and titles are, and some of the explanations, I just love it so much. So I know that this craving that I've had to just get deeper into the word is going to be met, you know. So I'm just so happy right now. I'm going to show it to you. It's really stunning, and yeah, can't wait. So here it is. It's called the Woman's Study Bible. It's pretty thick because it's a study Bible. And when you open it, it has a couple of things just like to keep record of your family, of your teachers, your spiritual role models, and that, those kind of things. And then the part that I love, right, is just like the headings and the insight that they already give, right? Like Joseph's cup, and Judah intercedes for Benjamin. Joseph revealed to his brothers, you know. When it starts a chapter, it tells you who wrote it, and it gives you context, the date, the background, the setting. You know, I just love that. And the audience, the purpose, and more into the title, the characteristics, and it outlines everything from every chapter. You know, like, I feel like it's just gonna really help me to know the Bible, you know. Because we read stories and stuff, but you don't always have context, and you don't always, like, yeah, like, I'm just, guys, like, I'm loving this, you know, the making of a covenant. Like, these are such important topics. The requirements of a covenant. Like, yo, wow. I am, yes, is like, this is the best thing I could have done for myself. Moses is born, okay, fine. A natural source of nourishment, breastfeeding. Who knows what they'll be talking about there. They explain, like, in the back in the day, breastfeeding was believed to be, wow. Oh my goodness, like, oh, yeah, obviously, you know, let's see the New Testament, what they cover there. Okay, this is still Psalms. Let's come to the New Testament. I love the Old Testament anyways, but obviously we are here, we are in the New, so we need to live and know that. Role relationships between men. Oh, the headship submission. Oh my goodness. Wow, Lord, thank you. Conforming to his purpose, words that build up. Equal, okay, fine. Children and parents, bond servants and masters, protector and provider, you know. And then, like, it also, okay, fine, it tells us the role of children, fatherhood, spiritual warfare. Like, every topic is just, like, dissected, and I love it. I love it. Yeah, you know, earlier on, I can't find it now. Ooh, pornography. My goodness. This is the Bible of the future. This is the Bible. This is the Bible of the future. Spiritual gifts, you know, government and citizenship, law and order. Aibo, I'm not available in the evenings any longer. Ngibizi. I'm here. This is where I am. If you're looking for me on the phone, I'm not there. Ngiseko angitholakali. I'm not even joking. This is the Bible I've been praying for. This is the Bible I've been needing. And I just cannot wait. Thank you, God. Yo. Wow.
Hi guys, so today is Friday afternoon, Friday evening, because it's like 6:15. We are launching the, well, it's been launched before. It is, we are back to in-person meetings as the MultiGen group of CFCI, and what that really entails is that the youth, the Hindu, so basically the young people and the old people are meeting to worship and pray and have a service together on a Friday night. It's more chill.
No.
Done the setup, and we're just waiting for people to come through, and we're gonna worship and praise and pray and enjoy ourselves in the presence of the Lord. We've set it up in a very intimate way, so we're just gonna, yeah. I think this room is actually also nice because it's quite intimate. It's like, yeah, it's like intimate. My brain.
can see your love in your eyes. I'm laying yourself down, raising up the broken to life.
Jesus changes the broken life into a fully restored life. He loves us all. He wants to give peace to you. He wants to give healing to you. His love is greater than everything that you face in the world. He loves to give you joy. He loves to give you peace in the family. If you want Jesus, come and pray with us. We love you.
So guys, this is the DIRTEA that I'm always raving about. As you can see, it comes in a really nice package and it's just arrived and I've opened it. Inside you find the sachet filled with the DIRTEA ingredients, which is the powder, the mushroom powder. Then you get an empty container, which is quite nice. I always like to leave it at the top of my kitchen counter, so that I can see it and I'm visibly reminded to have it every morning or every other morning. So as you can see, I'm opening the sachet and I am about to empty the contents into the container. So there it goes. And then I will simply just throw away the packet when I am done. There's also a sheet that sort of describes the rest of the other types of DIRTEA categories. Like I'd said to my friends earlier, there's so many different ingredients and you can just go on their website and choose the one that is appropriate for you. I will have a disclaimer that says this is not a paid partnership, it's not an advert. I truly just put people on to DIRTEA because it's done wonders for me and I really believe in the product. And if you have any issues with inflammation or lack of sleep or anything that they describe as one of the benefits, then go over and try it. I think it will really benefit you because it has truly, truly changed my life. It might break my heart tonight, but I'm gonna hold it tight. Oh, it feels like yellow. It hurts like yellow. You had to let me go. My loves, if you've watched until this far, thank you so much. You are a real one and I love you very much. Now I'm going to go ahead and end the vlog with some site pictures that I took on a site visit, two different sites actually. I didn't share much on what they're about, but in my next video I will talk more about what exactly I do, why we go to these sites and what it's all about. So cheers guys, have a good weekend, bye, see you next time.